Raiders from around the world, what's going on? It's Ricky Cadden back again with another free Friday stock review from Real Life Trading Australia. Hope you guys have had a sensational, profitable week. I did send out a few nice little buy the dip opportunities on a couple of casino stocks in my last review, so make sure you have gone and checked that out. But they are doing very, very nicely at the moment. But let's talk about the broader markets and what we've got in store for today. Now, on the SPY, guys, back on this day here, I did draw a little Mr. Squiggles here, which is this blue line. I mentioned that we were going to come back down, retest a little bit, probably come around the 100, and then possibly bounce. Now, we did end up bouncing in a really, really nice way. We actually did close above some very strong resistance levels. We even filled this particular retest gap that was not filled as well. So from here, guys, I really just think that we'll probably have a short-term pullback and then just mosey on higher on the SPY. The E-minis in my trading room, I did mention back on this day that we were most likely going to start to trend and bounce higher. This is going to be a particular profit-taking level that I would expect us to try and find some sort of resistance. But either way, guys, the markets are most definitely bullish. We do have a gorgeous inverted head and shoulders pattern, nice little triple bottom pattern happening as well on the E-minis. So be bullish, guys. Look to buy the dip. Here's ticker symbol COIN, good old Coinbase Global. Now, Coinbase, we had some absolutely fantastic volume. We are currently in a put sale on this one. Great volume. Nice little break above the 100 simple moving average, finding support, and now just slowly but surely cruising on higher. I do expect this one to start bouncing and rocket shipping higher, so keep your eyes on Coin for a nice little play to the upside. Here's Beyond Meat. Now, Beyond Meat is also following Mr. Squiggles very, very nicely from back here. I mentioned we would come back up to this resistance level, probably come back down. But based on this volume, probably not going to have that much of a pullback, because as you guys can see here, this is a double bottom. If we go down to an hourly time frame, you can really start to see, oh, there's actually a triple bottom here. But once you... As you guys can see, if we do come back down, it's probably only going to be to around about the neckline and then bounce around 106. So this will be a really interesting play on Beyond Meat. Earnings is also coming up right around the corner, just here around November, 1st of November. So that'll be really, really interesting, especially because we've been in a bit of a downtrend for quite some time on Beyond, but definitely a buy low location, as you can see here. Fantastic weekly candle. I mean, it is just an absolutely glorious weekly candle at that. So keep that one on your watch list, guys. Beyond Meat looks to definitely go higher very, very soon. Visa. Now, Visa is also one to keep on your watch list, guys. The reason being is we are at the 200 simple moving average. We're not going lower. Now, this is not the first time this has happened before. Usually, when we come back down to these really low levels, especially the 200 simple moving average, this is where we start to find some sort of reversals. As you can see here, if I just zoom out, you can really see that the 200 simple moving average is a phenomenal buying the dip long-term opportunity for a lot of investors out there. Now, I'm not saying that we are gonna just go to the moon here, but just, you know, based on previous market data, what has happened in the past, we could possibly see a move to the upside very, very soon. But I would be a little bit more longer term, guys, especially because we have had like a nice little 15% pullback on Visa, and usually we bounce after that particular move. We may see a little bit of a sideways action, but eventually we will most definitely go higher on Visa. Here's the Aussie 200. Now, we are currently at the 100 simple moving average, as you can see here, at a resistance level. Low volume, we have been declining, so we'll probably have a little bit of a pause action here. We might go sideways and bounce higher, or we may have a small little pullback. But all in all, guys, I would just stay bullish on the markets. Here's Newcrest Mining. Now, Newcrest Mining, ticker symbol NCM, has had a really nice bullish move just the last couple of weeks. Nice little 13% gain. On the weekly chart, looks absolutely phenomenal. I mean, look at this hammer candle. I mean, Chris Hemsworth himself, good old Thor, he would be pretty jealous of that particular candle right now. But we are currently at this particular downtrend line on the weekly chart, but I do think based on this volume that's coming in, we'll most likely see a nice little break to the upside, possibly a short little retest before we cruise on higher. And here's, wow, Woolworths. Now, Woolworths also struggling to go lower. You can see this by the wicks that have been formed, especially today's candle. We did come back down to this particular low from the start of the week, and we got this sensational increased volume on Woolworths. So at this point, guys, I would just be I'd be pretty bullish. I'd be pretty bullish. Great weekly candle as well. I mean, it's got all of the things. Nice little bounce off the 100 simple moving average on a weekly chart. So make sure that if you are looking at Woolworths, you will have a longer term perspective on this one, as it has been going sideways for almost 2 years now, which is absolutely crazy town. But good to see that we are starting to see some strength. Here's BHP. Now, BHP, I did mention in one of my last reviews that this is a really nice buy low location based on the weekly chart, simply because we are on the 200 simple moving average, and we have bounced off this level just a couple of times in the past. But, I mean, great pullback if you did get in. Currently trading at 38.86, we have now closed above the highs of the last 2 weeks, which is absolutely sensational. On the daily chart, we also have this cute little inverted head and shoulders pattern slowly forming. I don't think this one's going to be extremely bullish out the gate, but it, you know, if you are looking at a longer term play, you could also get into some sort of covered call position, or you could get into leaps or longer term options on this particular stock as well, and or put sales if you are a fan of puts. Here's crude oil. Now, crude oil, I have been mentioning, is going to continue bullish. If, as you guys can see here on the 30-minute chart, the 30-minute chart is slowly but surely starting to break out. But we are really just at the highest we've been since 2014. I did mention this. I'll go back to the monthly chart. You guys can see here, back in 2014, we are now breaking above these levels, so definitely going to see some higher prices at the fuel bowser as well. But crude oil, really nice breakout. You guys know I've been extremely bullish on crude. Have also been trading futures on crude most days as well, so I hope you guys have been too. Absolutely crushing it, as I have been giving you guys all the levels to watch out for. But crude, definitely in a bullish trend right now, and I don't think it's slowing down anytime soon. Here's gold. Now, gold, I did mention in the swing trading room back here that will most likely get some sort of pause at the 100 and 200 simple moving average. Also is this downward trend line here that has just been slowly getting rejected. So a lot of rejection here on the weekly chart. We are finally, at the moment, closing above the 100 simple moving average, which is really good to see. So really nice that we are staying above the 100 simple moving average. As long as we can stay above this, I will just be longer term bullish on gold. And last but not least is the Aussie dollar, absolutely scorching higher the last few weeks. If we do get a dip, guys, I would, you know, if we came back down to around 73, I don't think that's going to happen. But if we did, it'll be a nice little dip buying opportunity. If we come back down to around this level, we'll probably get a consolidation. As we build pressure, I'll just be getting ready to be long on the AUD/USD. All right, guys, I'll be back next week. And until next time, love life, live life, and trade it. If you want me to review any stocks, make sure you leave it in the comment section below. Have a great weekend. I'll see you soon. Bye.